Hello, happy Sabbath, and I hope you had a Merry Christmas too. My name is Courtney, and I'm here to do Junior Sabbath School with you this morning. I hope you had a wonderful Christmas yesterday. Just what a fun holiday, the gifts, giving and receiving, and just the spirit of the holidays, the lights, and all the special activities. Even with COVID, there's been so many cool Christmas activities available out there, and I hope you've been able to enjoy all this stuff of the season. But today, we're going to do one more lesson about what is the real meaning of the season? And I you might know this already, but December 25th is not the day Jesus was born. You know, there's all different kinds of speculation, but we know it's not in December that we adopted this holiday based on existing holidays when people were converting to Christianity. And there's all kinds of debate about that, whether we should celebrate or not. But all that aside, it's a great time to think about the nature of Jesus, his divinity and his humanity, and just all of the amazing events that surrounded his birth. And I think the birth of Christ is like the most like clear, the birth story, the story of Jesus as a baby is the biggest proof of his fulfillment of prophecy, blah, 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 blah. The biggest proof of prophecy that he is the Messiah. I mean, obviously his death and resurrection and what he went through is the other thing, but I think so much surrounding his birth, obviously the location and the time and the signs, and it all fell together, and Jesus is the one. And so when we look into this scripture today in Matthew 2, we see the Magi, and they're studying, and they see the star, and they study the scripture and all of this, and the King of the Jews is here. We need to go. And so they see the star. They go to Jerusalem, and everyone's like, what are you talking? King of the Jews? Herod's like, excuse me? You know? And it's just amazing that sometimes it's right in our faces, you guys. I mean, it was the shepherds in the field that were ready to hear the angel's message, not the scribes and the rabbis. And it was these magi, right, from the east, not Herod and the Jews in Jerusalem, that were expecting and realizing that the king was here, that Jesus was born. So we have to be so careful to not miss obvious signs in our own lifetime. Guys, Jesus is coming back, and we're seeing all the signs. And I know people have said this for a long time, but more than ever, things are coming together, and we can see how quickly things change. I mean, we started this whole COVID mess back in like March. It's December. It's almost 2021. Very soon, it will have been 1 year since this all started. And so to think how quickly things progress, and it's just, we can't keep our eyes closed. We can't be the Jews in Jerusalem that were not expecting the Messiah to come. They were waiting for thousands of years. They waited for so long for the Messiah that they just kind of, it just got put out of their mind. It didn't feel like something that was going to happen anytime soon. They neglected the study of those scriptures and prophecies. And then look what happened. Jesus came. It's going to be the same. It's going to be the same. Don't neglect the signs that you see. And I know you're young, and even I'm super young. But guys, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. We can still be ready for Christ. Those shepherds were ready for him as a baby. We can be ready for him to return in clouds of glory. So we're going to talk just a little bit about the Magi. And what I love about the Magi is I think it's so cool, the gifts that they bring, the symbolism in those gifts, the frankincense and myrrh and gold. And these are very kingly gifts. And so they're very symbolic and representative of who Christ is, but they're also super practical for them. The Magi come and bring them these gifts for a king, but you know, they have to flee to Egypt, right? Because Joseph is told in a dream, got to get out of here. And so these gifts were able, they were able to use these gifts to meet their needs, to sell and to meet their needs, to take care of Jesus and to make this journey into Egypt. So I just think that's so cool. And similarly, it's also cool that they go back then after Herod's death to Nazareth in Galilee. So born in Bethlehem and the Egypt thing and all of this is fulfilling prophecy about the Messiah. It's incredible. It's so cool. There's just proof after proof after proof that Jesus is Christ. He is the Messiah. And he's not just the Messiah for Israel. He is the Messiah. He is the King. He is the Christ of all people. I want to read to you. I'm going to conclude by reading to you this awesome quote. It's actually from Ellen White. And there's some Bible verses in it, references that I'll mention after as well. God's word, the Bible, is a trusted guide. Psalm 119:105. The Bible, when studied prayerfully, will lead us into a saving relationship with Jesus. Yes, the whole Bible tells of Christ from the first record of creation, for without him was not anything made that was made, to the closing promise, behold, I come quickly. We are reading of his works and listening to his voice. So we see Job 1:3, Revelation 22:12. If you would become acquainted with this Savior, study the Holy Scriptures. Like the wise men from the time of Jesus, we too can choose to be guided by the light of God's word, for the Bible will lead us to the Savior. This is something that I've learned as an adult that is very comforting to me. In scripture, we see so many miracles and we so many different signs, like the star and then Jesus healing and just all of the crazy stuff, right? All of the dreams and all of the guys. We don't necessarily need those things because we have scripture. We have this. This is our guide. These are the signs. We don't need all of these things to prove to us what we're seeing or feeling or hearing is real, because we can stand on this Bible. We can stand on scripture. It has the answers. It has the miracles. It has everything in it. It is our light and guide. So I would just ask, especially entering the new year, take the opportunity of a new year to rededicate yourself to studying scripture. Even if you're struggling with God or having doubts, please look at your Bible, read it, learn more about it. And even if it's just out of pure knowledge seeking and not seeking a relationship with Jesus, I promise you, it's not going to leave you unchanged. It's incredible. It's a living book. It's living. God's word is alive. And so is Jesus Christ. So friends, I want to have a word of prayer with you and I'll send you on your way. Okay? Father in heaven, thank you so much for each person here with me online. Lord, I ask your blessing over this Sabbath and over each of our lives. Father, you're so good. Thank you for the sacrifice of Jesus Christ that started with a baby in a manger. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. All right, you guys, I'll see you next time. Have a great rest of 2020.